I apologize for having my back to people, but I have a question for the state of Hawaii. As you know, I was opposed to the state signing on this administrative order of consent. I thought that 22 years to come up with safe tanks was an unacceptable amount of time. I thought that there should be a standard in the administrative order of consent for double-lined tanks or the equivalent. And instead, there's a best practicable alternative that allows the Navy to consider cost to them for building the tanks and not the cost to us for having the aquifer contaminated. But that said, the Department of Health recommended to the governor that he sign the administrative order of consent. So I came here tonight understanding that this was a joint meeting by the state, the EPA, and the Navy. And I understood that the state and EPA have rejected the recent work product that the Navy put forward for some very specific reasons, 51 pages. And I expected that to be explained to us tonight so that we can be assured that the objective bodies that are overseeing the Navy will be responding to the people of Hawaii. Now, gentlemen of the Navy, I believe that you are sincere, but you do not have the authority to commit the Navy to anything. And as you mentioned, you're going to be out of here in a year and a half. There's a reason why this administrative order of consent has the state and the EPA as the overseeing bodies. So I guess I have a request for the state and a question for the state. The request is, at the next public meeting, can you and the EPA take the lead so that you can explain from your positions where do you think we are in the administrative order of consent? The question I have, I guess it's actually a two-part question. First of all, how much delay can we expect now that this latest work product has been rejected and the Navy's going to have to go back to the drawing board? Because by pushing back that work product, we're pushing back every single deadline. So now we're moving from 22 years to what? We're at year one. So we're already experiencing our first delay at year one. I have some concerns. And the other question I have for the state is, do you, as Department of Health, view your role here as purely as the local arm for the EPA, or do you think you also have an additional responsibility under our state constitution to hold the Navy to a higher standard to protect the public trust resource of our water system?
Solid has this approach for 22 years. And, we have taken actions against the University of Hawaii for messing up their laboratory facilities, going after the Navy, going after Waimanawa Gulch. But we continue to do that because that is our charge, that's our responsibility to the public. It's important for me to say that I'm really happy you guys are here because in many years past, I've gone to hearings when nobody shows up. You can be passionate about what you have, you may disagree the solution ahead of time, but we have to have a path forward. We could say, no, we screwed up, shut it down, and we would spend years and years in court with the Navy. They would argue that it is such an important strategic facility that they're not going to move on. The AOC does provide a mechanism which is set for 22 years. There is a potential extension for additional 5 years, but it does go on and on. In 22 years, well, in hopefully in 18 months, we will have the first selection of alternative moving forward to showing that we can fix the problem. If they can't fix the problem, then they will move forward. If they don't get tanks fixed by the 22-year period, they're done. None of those tanks that have not been fixed will be continued to operate. So we have a responsibility to you, the public, just like the Board of Water Supply and ensuring that we have safe drinking water, and we hold people to accountable to doing the work necessary. The Navy's agreed to take these measures to do the investigations. There are many pieces in this AOC. Part of it is looking at how can they improve their inspection monitoring process? How can they prevent human errors, how can they actually build a new structure or modify the structure so that we can prevent any future losses? You know, it may be impossible to say that we went to zero leaks, but every step forward that we take results in improvements and better accountability for all of us. And ultimately, we can stop further releases. You know, we don't have to worry about what happens now, how much worse can it get. The reality is that when I started looking at these records, go back to 1983, that's the last time I see records of information releases. These releases are old. They happened, you know, before many of us, you know, before I came to Oahu. I came here in 1981. By then, all this stuff had happened. And I was shocked. I said, geez, you know, I mean, I didn't even know this facility existed. But it happened. It's a reality. It is simply our dependence on different types of economic engines that are in our state. We have a problem with our drinking water in the Emma Plain because of 100 years of agricultural work where people use pesticides to increase productivity. And you know, 30, 40 years after that process, after those companies are gone, we're paying the price of cleaning up that water, and we're going to continue doing it. We're going to continue to use that water. That's the reality. So we don't want to be in that point where we're going to spend millions and millions of dollars year after year cleaning up the water. We would like to come up with a remedy that can stop it, but we think that we're bringing as many of the best minds to the table to figure out how do we make it better, how do we stop it, and if we can't stop it, then it's time to move on to something.